Prentice, I see you've touched down on Alderaan, Jaysa Wilson's home planet where Noman Carr found her. Excellent. You will discover everything you can about this Padawan and destroy everyone she loves there.
What are we trying to achieve?
It is the same mandate as Tatooine. Assault Jaysa from afar, stir her emotions, and flush her to the surface. Unfortunately, with the civil war for the Alderaanian throne raging, your contact, Duke Kendo of House Thule, has become unreliable. Kendo was supposed to find Jaysa Wilson's family for you, but it seems he's distracted. You must undistract him.
I will handle it.
Kendo is a political creature. The consequences of failing me are abstract for him. Once they are made concrete, he'll cooperate. You'll find him in the House Thule executive chambers. Make haste.
You lack patience, Duke Kendo. There are standard procedures that must be adhered to.
Your disregard for our family rules is appalling. You are an abomination. Goodbye, cousin.
Fools. They won't be feeling much of anything for long.
Duke Kendo, Darth Barriss sent me.
What? You're not on my schedule. I don't appreciate being interrupted. Barriss isn't even on my radar, Sith. I have a war to wage and personal ambitions to achieve here.
Aiding Barriss may help you achieve those ambitions.
Please, don't try to manipulate me. I have Sith bodyguards of my own now. Tell Barriss I'm through being his lackey. Femres, show this intruder out. On his feet or his back, makes no difference to me.
I'm sorry, Duke Kendo. We are assigned to protect you and support your interests in the struggle for Alderaan. But we serve the Emperor first, and we will not cross Darth Barriss or his apprentice.
It's good to know some people have respect.
We consider you an ally, friend.
Okay. That was unexpected. It seems I may have been hasty regarding your master's needs. How can I make amends?
Do your job and all will be well.
I pledge the same level of focus that had me so absorbed in my own work. I pledge myself to your directives, and as I aid you, perhaps you'll be moved to help me in mine.
We'll see. Time will tell.
I am focused and at your service. As I recall, Darth Barriss wanted information on a young Alderaanian girl who was taken off planet to train with Jedi Master Noman Carr. I was to locate her family so that you could, well, send the girl a message.
That is my understanding.
The truth is, information about this girl is difficult to come by. I managed only one lead. Noman Carr's Padawan fits the description of the former handmaiden of a noblewoman in House Alder named Lady Renata. I've questioned her already, but Renata is protected by House Alder's greatest champion. The man has never met his match in melee.
Sounds like a challenge.
No doubt about it. The man isn't very bright, but he never leaves her side. If I may, once you've eliminated her protector and gotten what you need, I would personally be very indebted if you'd arrange to have Lady Renata brought to us for questioning.
I'll take it under consideration.
All right. I just hope the mood strikes you. While House Alder is a small player on Alderaan, it is affiliated with House Organa. Therefore, Lady Renata's estate is in hostile territory and very well defended. Be cautious.
Be ready for my return.
I do hope to see you soon. Until then...
My lady, we have intruder.
Lady Renata, I seek the family of your former handmaiden, Jaysa Wilson.
What's this nonsense you're spouting? I don't know what you're talking about.
Lady, Let me kill this Sith like the last one Duke Kendo sent.
Windred, you don't need my permission to kill an enemy that comes barging through my door. Make it fast.
Violence isn't necessary. I just need information.
All you need is my sword through your neck. Lady, I... sorry.
This can't be. I'm sorry I ordered him to kill you, Sith. I hope you don't hold it against me. You see, I've been fending off Duke Kendo's advances for some time, and I just assumed you were here for him. If you're not working for the Duke, I'll gladly cooperate. You mentioned a girl, yes? Jaysa someone?
Jaysa Wilson. Kendo told me she used to be your handmaid.
Kendo is a liar. I was aware of the young handmaiden who left Alderaan with the Jedi Master. And I did hear the name Jaysa Wilson, but you're mistaken. I didn't know her. The girl never served me.
It seems I've been misinformed.
I'm sure Duke Kendo will double his efforts to help you find what you seek. The Duke congratulates you on your impressive venture into House Alday. I'm here to take the fair lady to him.
No! Don't let him take me to that pig! I do know who the girl worked for. I'll tell you all I can, if only you'll keep me from Duke Kendo.
You have my attention.
Then we are agreed. Good. Before she left with the Jedi, Jaysa Wilson was the handmaiden of Jacel Organa of House Organa. They were inseparable. Before the war, Jacel was an aristocrat, like myself. Now she leads the Organan troops against House Ulgo.
That's an excellent lead. Thank you.
Oh, a mannered Sith. How refreshing. You're welcome.
The Duke will know where to find Jacel Organa, and how to reach her. If you let me deliver Lady Renata to him, I'm sure Kendo will happily shed light on the situation for you.
The lady isn't going anywhere.
Thank you. It's good to know some Sith have a sense of honor.
Fine. As I said, I will not oppose you, nor will I defy your decision here. I meant what I said. I'm sure Kendo can help you find and confront Jazel. You should consult with him on it.
I'll do just that.
I will update Kendo, so he is ready for you.
Despite the destruction you caused, I hold you in high esteem, Sith. I only hope you make that worm Kendo pay for misleading you. Take nothing he says at face value.
I appreciate your advice.
I'm sure you'll be fine. Goodbye.
I heard you decided not to allow Fimres to bring the Lady Renata to me. I am most disappointed.
Don't cry too hard. You'll get over it.
You don't know me very well. By denying my claim to Renata, you certainly aren't providing me much incentive to help you. Where's my motivation?
Renata would have been a distraction for you.
And now you have my full attention. Is that it? I see the logic. So, Fimres tells me the lead was fruitful. Although Lady Renata was not the girl's mistress, she knew who was. Jazelle Organa. I should say, General Jazelle Organa. Now you have to track her down, which poses a bit of a problem.
Some elaboration is required.
Jazelle Organa leads the Organa War against House Ulgo. Her headquarters is protected by an impenetrable force field. No firepower can breach it. The force field allows Jazelle and her advisors to be stationed very close to the front and maintain a more hands-on command.
Sounds like General Jazelle knows what she's doing.
As smart as she is, there must be a way to overcome... Wait. Yes. A force field needs power to maintain itself, yes? So, if we manage to cut the power... And I bet I know exactly where Jazelle is getting her juice. If I'm right, you could just walk through the front door.
Sounds very promising.
Almost all the power on Alderaan is supplied by the planetary generator. Jazelle must be piggybacking the system to power her force field. Several of my fellows do this to maintain their special security needs. A precise charge at the generator will force fail-safes to fire. The planet won't miss a beat, but ancillary systems, like Giselle's force field, will have to be manually reset, which could take some time.
What do you think of this plan?
I'll tell you, I just don't trust this guy.
What's a charming creature you are. Believe me, this is the only way to gain access to the Organa headquarters. Vimres, fetch a 7-stroke-7 detonator from my arms cabinet there, and give it to our friend.
As you wish.
The Alderaan power generator is located above the Strait Valley, and it boasts the planet's most advanced security systems. You'll have to fight your way in, set the charge, then fight your way out before the boom. It won't be easy.
Consider me warned.
Once you've detonated the generator, you'll still have to wade through Giselle's surrounding army and invade her headquarters before her force field is reset. I'll be eagerly tracking your progress. Good luck.
General, our standing army outside is being wiped out. Someone or something is on its way here.
My technicians almost have the force field reset, but we're still a sitting duck.
There have been several assassinations of House Thule officials whose security systems were down by the generator explosion. In my opinion, House Ulgo is behind all this.
Your opinion is about to change. I'm here for information on Jaysa Wilson's family.
Intruder!
Giselle, get behind me.
None of you panic. I'll handle this. Sith, did I hear you right? You've perpetrated all this in search of my former handmaiden?
I doubt you would have taken my call.
It might have worked. I'm a practical woman. You have decimated my forces outside. They were to be deployed to secure a part of my front that's about to fall. Now I have no reinforcements. You seek information only I have, and my front needs bolstering. Perhaps we can help each other.
That sounds reasonable.
I'm glad we see eye to eye. Now, on my left flank, there's a tunnel between my forces and House Ulgo's that has been hard-pressed by the enemy. I have only a ragtag troop defending this tunnel, and Ulgo is about to attack. You must repel the enemy forces.
I will accomplish it.
It is strange to say to a Sith, but you have my and House Organa's thanks. What's left of my forces at the tunnel choke point are being led by Lieutenant Dargus. I'll let Dargus know you're coming. He'll contact me as soon as you've succeeded. Assuming you do.
I won't disappoint you.
I have a good feeling you won't. Goodbye, Sith. As uncomfortable as it is to say, I hope we speak again soon.
All right, man. This is it. With the captain dead, it falls on me to rally what's left of us. I guess the reinforcements aren't gonna make it. We'd better get ready. Ulgo forces are fast approaching. I can feel the tunnel walls shaking.
Consider me your reinforcements. I'm here to help.
Lieutenant, we've been flanked.
No, wait. General Giselle sent word that a Sith would be coming to our aid, but I thought I must have misheard her.
Sir, I'm not trusting a Sith, no way.
We're drastically outnumbered, Sergeant. The General's given an order, and besides, without help, we die for sure.
The rest of the men and me aren't sticking around for a suicide run.
If you men follow the Sergeant, you'll miss a great victory.
If we stay, either Ulgo kills us or the Sith does. Who's leaving with me?
I don't think so, Sarge. Maybe with the Sith at our side, we can repel the attack. Yeah, and I don't relish the idea of being a deserter anyway.
Glad to hear it, men. Sergeant, you are relieved, and I will report this to General Giselle personally.
Now you're sounding like a leader, Lieutenant.
Even though I understand the instinct to run, desertion can't be tolerated. Get out of here, Sergeant. Let the real soldiers fight the good fight.
Lieutenant, the Ulgo forces are coming now. What do we do?
Stand your ground and fight like men.
Take your positions. This is it. That was amazing. They just kept coming and coming, and you're a war machine.
I appreciate your observation.
You might want to stop all the chatter. Those bozos are regrouping for another attack. Get ready.
Let them come. They'll find I'm more than their match.
Here they come! There's blood all over me! It's everywhere! Everywhere!
Calm down, Lieutenant. Your wounds are superficial.
Hey, I just snuck a peek into the tunnel. There's a heap of those laser brains getting ready for another swipe.
Let's stay sharp.
Get ready to be overrun! It's a miracle! The Ulgo forces are retreating! You did it!
I couldn't have done it without you, Lieutenant.
You are too kind, Sith. I'll get General Giselle on the holo for you. She'll be very relieved.
What's the word, Dargus? I assume that since you're hailing me, the day is won?
Yes, General. The Sith single-handedly turned back the entire attack.
Sith, as painful as it has been, it seems you've come through. I hope you're not expecting a thank you.
War makes strange bedfellows.
This experience has certainly proven that. Now, I promise to tell you where Jaysa Wilson's parents could be found. They have been servants in Castle Organa for many years. Sith, the Wilsons are a simple, innocent, hard-working people. They deserve your mercy.
I'll take it under consideration.
That's all I can ask.
Goodbye, Sith. And thanks for saving my life.
General Jessa's warning was true. The Sith has come for us.
Men, rally around me. The fight is upon us. I didn't think a single assailant could make it through Castle Organa's defenses all the way here to us.
The Organa guards are well trained. It was quite a challenge.
It will feel like child's play compared to facing me, Sith. You will not harm Parvin and Gregor Wilson. I vow it.
No one has to get hurt over this.
So, you murdered countless innocents to get here, and now you want to make friends.
Please, Master Jedi. I realize the Sith can't be trusted, but I want to hear this.
Fine. Say your piece, Sith. I'm not going anywhere, and I will protect them, no matter what.
I'm here to do things for them, not to them.
Then there's no need for further violence. Sith, what is it you want?
Gregor, this has to do with Jaysa. I just know it.
Yes, I'm here because of your daughter.
I knew she shouldn't have gone with the Jedi. Now the Empire is hunting her. Sith, Jaysa was our life. She was going to marry Organa nobility so that we would no longer have to be servants.
When she left, we sacrificed that dream. We don't know anything about Jaysa now. We were told we would probably never see her again. We are mere servants. What could you want with us?
I'm here to deliver you from servitude.
You want to help us?
No, Gregor. The Sith is toying with us before killing us.
Heed your wife's warning, Gregor Wilson. Sith are devious and demented.
Is that what you mean, Sith? By killing us, you end our life of servitude? Can't you spare us?
If you align with the Empire, you live.
What do you mean by this? What is to happen to us if we do as you say?
I'll see to it that you live like kings.
You dirty, no good Cretan!
Parvin, Jaysa has gone off to a life of discipline and detachment. We are unlikely to ever see her again. The Sith is offering us a way out of this, a way to live.
Jaysa is sensitive, Gregor. She will feel our betrayal. It will fester in her. Don't you see? This Sith is banking on that.
Did you hear me say you'll live like kings?
My wife can't see the big picture. You offer a choice between death or pledging ourselves to our daughter's enemy. I choose that Parvin and I live in the arms of the Empire, and I trust that my daughter will understand and remain strong.
Your wife has to agree as well.
Please, my sweet. Stand with me on this.
My place is with you, Gregor. As long as we're alive, there's hope.
We are in agreement. We shall embrace the Empire. Tell us what happens next.
You'll receive instructions at the Imperial landing.
I'm so glad you've all found an accord. But there's still the matter of you being our enemy, Sith. Not only will I not allow the Wilsons to do this, but you had yourself a killing spree getting here. That can't go unpunished.
This is a peaceful solution, Jedi. Honor it.
Yes, Master Volrider. Stay true to the Jedi Code and keep the peace. Too many have died already today.
Gregor and I go of our own free will and spare this house any further pain.
This doesn't sit right. But I can't attack someone walking in peace. Even a Sith.
You just saved your life.
The code is everything, Sith. But I wouldn't expect you to respect it. Leave out the back door to avoid further casualties. I'll say nothing further.
Apprentice. The Sith Fenris who attends Duke Kendo was able to patch me through to you directly. Excellent. I am seeking an update. News of your search for Jason Wilson's family has reached me, and I am quite concerned.
What news have you heard, my lord?
Duke Kendo contacted me to tell me that you have been busying yourself with personal exploits and disregarding my mission.
What exactly did he say about me?
In a moment. First, the more important subject. Tell me you found the family of Noman Kar's Padawan. Tell me they have been taken care of.
I made them swear allegiance to the Empire and sent them to Dromund Kaas.
Really? Excellent thinking. As I torture them, their pain will scream into the galaxy and torment their daughter.
I promised them riches, and I believe it will be more effective if they live fruitfully.
Very conniving. The happier they are under Imperial rule, the more it will tear at the Jedi's heart. I would make it so. You eclipse my greatest hopes for you, and prove you belong at my side. Which makes my susceptibility to Duke Kendo's gossip about you all the more foolish.
You said it. I didn't.
I have learned to follow all roads to their conclusion. So when I hear something alarming, I always pursue it. First off, Kendo said that you set an explosion that caused the death of several Thule dignitaries.
That was his doing, not mine.
It must be politically advantageous for him to disavow his role in such a thing. Kendo also said that you helped the Republic defend their front in Organa's war against House Ulgo, painting you as a traitor.
Doing so expedited my mission.
Well, I do not care about the trivial war on Alderaan. All that matters to me is that your mission is complete. For whatever reason, the man has taken it upon himself to slander you. I have no further use for Duke Kendo. Punish him however you please. If it were me, he'd pay severely.
I'm interested to hear what he has to say for himself.
Do what you will, but quickly. Until we destroy the threat of Jason Wilson, nothing else is important. Goodbye, apprentice.
Come in. I heard of your success, and I'm so very pleased for you.
Cut the antics, Kendo.
Is there a problem?
Barriss told me you called me a traitor and blamed me for the murder of your fellow Thuls.
Oh, I see. How awkward for me. Allow me to explain. I realized when you blew up the power generator, several of my rivals would be exposed. So I seized the opportunity to eliminate them. I had company when I was speaking with your master, and I needed to keep my fellow house members blind to my maneuvering.
That is a lie. You contacted Barriss yourself, alone.
The truth comes out.
I only wanted Barriss to know that I was looking out for him. It was harmless. I knew you would succeed, and all Barriss would care about was that. Please. Please don't kill me. Fimres, you and your men are assigned to me. If I am attacked, you must defend.
If Darth Barriss's apprentice decides you die, we will not intercede.
No one dies today, but he must leave Alderaan forever.
Give up everything I've worked so hard for?
That is your punishment.
Very stiff and painful one. I will leave this planet, my home, immediately. A broken man.
Oh, you're breaking my heart.
I know there is no sympathy for me. Goodbye, Sith. I shall never return to this place.
What a sad, pathetic man. Serving him was a daily dose of nausea.
I can imagine.
Now we report back to our master on the Council. We will be paying attention to your exploits. Farewell.
You crushed Alderaan under your boot, Apprentice. I am incredibly impressed. The planet will feel the sting for years to come.
I am your humble servant, Master.
Noman Kaar's Padawan can no longer hide in anonymity. I am pleased. By rooting out this Jaesa Wilson's parents, you have reached across the galaxy to strike a sharp blow at our enemies. Every lead followed perfectly. Every planet ravaged. Our adversary is growing antsy. I can feel it. Expect news soon. Barriss out.
My lord, I thought it prudent not to interrupt Darth Barriss. We received a recorded transmission. It is queued when you are ready.
Sith, I'm Jaesa Wilson. My master, Noman Kaar, has no idea I'm sending this message. Let's be real. We both know this isn't about us.
Ah. The hunted seeks the hunter.
Our masters pretend otherwise, but this is personal. You and I are only pawns in their private war, and those I care about are caught in the middle. It has to stop.
Wow. Gotta give it to her. She sure got guts.
She certainly does.
I appreciate directness. And as merciful as your actions have been, it's time you stopped this passive-aggressive campaign. This message includes coordinates where I'll be waiting in my ship. Let's discuss this face-to-face. No more nonsense.
What do you think of that, Captain?
It could be a trap, my lord. Noman Kaar may have put her up to it.
Hey, don't listen to Captain Paranoid here. I don't think it's a trap. I trust her.
Thanks for the input, Vet.
The coordinates are set, my lord. We can rendezvous with her ship whenever you give the word.
Well, well. We're going to have to thank Noman Kaar after all. The Sith showed.
Stand down, Sith. The Padawan you seek is not here. Master Kaar discovered her plan and talked her out of it.
It's not your day. You were expecting one lowly little Padawan to crush. And instead, you get us.
I should have known this wasn't going to be easy.
Just like a Sith, always looking for a shortcut.
I'm Alden. This is Xylix. We are fully trained Jedi Knights and more than your match. You should submit.
Of course, we have yet to encounter a Sith who had the sense to surrender. You all seem bent on having us destroy you.
I have no quarrel with you. Let's just go our separate ways.
Now, why would we agree to just let you go?
Xylix, we assume this Sith would engage, as all others we faced have. If that's not the case...
No, Alden. This Sith will continue to hunt Noman Kaar and his Padawan. We must end the threat for good.
True Jedi don't attack to kill. The light side demands temperance.
Who are you to lecture about the light side? The Sith force us to take measures like this.
You, Sith, pose an exception. Your vile attempts to hurt Noman Kaar and Jaesa Wilson are provocation enough.
You don't know my motivations.
Come on! It doesn't take a genius to know you came here to destroy. Your presence is all the confirmation we need. Right, Alden?
No. Xylix, I'm unsure. Master Kaar claims this Sith means Jaesa harm, but we have no proof.
Master Kaar's word is proof enough. I have no crisis of conscience, assuming his assessment is sound.
That's an assumption I cannot make, my friend. I will not engage. I must walk away. And I urge you to do the same.
You may have derailed Alden's resolve, Sith, but your luck ends there. I'll take you on myself.
You're going to regret that.
Never! I yield to you! Damn Alden for leaving me to face you alone.
The result would have been the same.
Your strength is undeniable. Is there such power in the dark side?
I'll leave you to ponder your future.
I am a broken man.
Apprentice, the timing of this call is fortuitous. I was just about to contact you with news.
I'm eager to hear it.
I'm pleased to report that your exploits have been successful. I have received a transmission from Noman Carr, calling me out, if you will, challenging me to face him to the death. Our enemy has become desperate.
He must have lost his mind.
Your efforts to disrupt his precious Padawan have unnerved him. He seeks to turn the tides. Carr fails to understand I have outgrown our personal dispute. He expects me to jump at the chance of strangling him. He will be unprepared for you.
Just tell me where to go.
The duel is to happen on Hutter, at the site of Noman Carr's betrayal so long ago. A fitting place for this to end. Defeat him, but do not kill him. His torment will reach out to his Padawan. He will be the bait that brings her to you.
Sounds like a plan.
I can feel Jaysa Wilson on the verge of breaking, and Carr's desperate actions confirm it. Subdue the Master, and the pupil will come to save him. I have foreseen it.